and the map reduce, whatever we have seen, we have the most important topic that is in the Hadoop framework known as the Hive. What exactly do you mean by the Hive? What is Hive? As you may be able to see it on the screen, that Hive is something that is a bee. Okay? So why we need Hive, and who was the company, and who has developed some Hive, and what were the some features of the Hive? So now we have to see what is the Hive. On the screen you may be also able to see that Hive is a data warehouse infrastructure to process structured data in Hadoop. Whatever the data we have in Hadoop, that is the structured one, because almost we have the unstructured data. 70% of the data we are generating is the unstructured, but some of the data we have that is the structured one, okay, and that can be processed using the Hive. Hive is simply a warehouse data. How it will work? So whatever the data we are generating, suppose we when you are going to chat with the Facebook, what will happen in the Facebook Messenger or the Facebook chat window? Whatever the message you are typing, your friends are getting, okay, that data is the totally structured data, and that is processed by this Hive. Okay, who are the company who has developed this Hive? So Hive was developed by the company known as Facebook only. Later on it has given this to the Apache Software Foundation, so it becomes the open source. Okay, so there may be a certain chances that whatever the data we are going to place in the RDBMS, whether it is the structure or not, so suppose if the our data is the structured data, there may be a chances that we will not able to get means process that data, store is not problem, we can store that data in the RDBMS, but there may be a chances that due to the bulk amount of that structured data, there may be a chance that your processing should be low. So for that purpose the Hive came into concept, and it was given by the Facebook. Now we have to see what are the different problems where there is a need for the Hive. So right now some of the companies that is known as the Amazon's something and Facebook, all are using the Hive concepts. Now we have to see something about the Hive. What is the exact definition for Hive? Then Hive is one of the easiest to use of high level MapReduce framework. Suppose if you are using the MapReduce concept, there may be a chance that you will be able to get some problems. Okay, because the MapReduce is a high level language, and in there a lot many codes you have to write for processing your normal work. So there may be a chance that you will get certain problems. To overcome these problems, we have to get some easiest technology, something like Pig. So in last class we have seen some configurations that was done in the case of the Pig only, and that was done in the same programming was done in the case of the MapReduce. So on comparing with the MapReduce and Pig, which one was the better, which is the easiest to maintain and use? Any answers from your side? As we have seen the some examples of the Pig and MapReduce both. Now I got one answer, that is a Pig. Yeah, why? Because whatever the code we are writing for the word count simple problem, in the MapReduce it takes a lot many times some along with the some memory spaces. So we have to write our programming in such a way that it should be optimal. Then for that case we need the Pig. Similar to the Pig, we have also one technology that is known as the Hive, which is also related to the MapReduce only, and this Hive was developed by the Facebook. Now on the screen you may be able to see one definition, that what exactly the Hive is. So Hive is a data warehouse infrastructure, means whatever the data we are going to produce, it will be first stored in the warehouse infrastructure, and that will be processed by the technology or the tool that is known as the Hive. That is the most common technology in our structured data case. This Hive resides all on the top of the Hadoop. what exactly this means. What it means that the hives resides on the top of the Hadoop? Any answers from your side? From the beginning only we have seen that MapReduce resides on the top of the Hadoop. What does it mean? The same meaning here is that Hive resides on the top of the Hadoop. What is the actual meaning by saying this line? That Hive resides on the top of the Hadoop. Any answers? No answers. Simply a single reason is that if it is saying that it resides on the top of the Hadoop, it means that for running the Hive commands, we need that Hadoop should be present in your system. Okay. That is the simple meaning of the things. Wherever you are getting the question that MapReduce resides on the top of the Hadoop or Pig resides on the top of the MapReduce. So it simply means that for running that MapReduce is required. Okay. Same thing here, that Pig, that is the Hive, resides on the top of the Hadoop. Why this is done for? And Hive is mostly the querying and querying language, like to the SQL. Okay. Now we will see certain features and something about the Hive. So before you are going to write your query in the Hive using the Hadoop technology, so what are the different requirements you should have for going to write the Hive query? Because in the market, wherever, whenever you are going to face any interview, there may be a requirement only there that the MapReduce. If you are going for the Hadoop developer, then there is a requirement for the MapReduce, then Pig and Hive. That these three are the most common requirement by each of the companies, and that is the basic requirement. If you are working on the Hadoop, you should be aware of the three things: MapReduce, Pig and Hive. So you have seen the basic working of the MapReduce. Also in the last classes we have seen the Pig, a complete structure, whatever the requirements of the Pig you have seen. Also along with that you have seen certain examples that is related to the Pig and how it is somewhat advantageous and preferred by the users over the MapReduce. Now here we have the topic that is known as the Hive. Before going to write any query using the Hive, what is the requirements? So here also the basic requirement is same, that the person should be aware of the core Java, and you should be aware of something that is known as the SQL concepts. Okay. And if you are working with the Hadoop, then it by default you should be have the knowledge of the Hadoop file systems and some Linux operating systems, whether it is a Linux or the Ubuntu or whatever the flavor you are using of the Unix operating system, you should have the knowledge. That is the minimum requirement for going for the Hive. Now what exactly this Hive is? So we can say that this Hive is similar to the SQL. Okay. That is for processing the query from the database. Here, whatever the SQL command we are using in the concept of Hive, and that all query is known as HiveQL or HQL. Okay. So no one is going to respond anything. Either it may be totally out of the mind to all
no,
the
no, person. No.
Okay.
No.
Or it yeah. is or it is 100% clear. There may be only two chances.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nothing
yeah.
is clear and 100%
Yeah. So what exactly the Hive? You are familiar, most of you are familiar with the database partner, the SQL. I am not going to tell that you should be have the deep knowledge in the database, but you should know what is exactly this Hive is, means what exactly the SQL is. You are familiar with the SQL, na? So like create, select, whatever the command you are going to use for the SQL, the same we can use in the Hive. So Hive also have one SQL command that is known as the HiveQL. If you are the working people of the Java, then you should be knowledge of the something that is known as the in the case of the Hibernate. Hibernate has also the same query language that is known as the HQL. Here also in the case of Hive, that is known as the HiveQL or HQL. Okay. This, what is the purpose of this? What is the purpose of this one? Hive? This is only for the purpose that is working on the structured data. In the case of Hadoop, we have seen something that is working on the unstructured data in the concept of Hadoop. But now this Hive is something related to the structured data in our Hadoop. So this is almost similar to the SQL only. So Hive is a warehouse, okay, developed by Facebook. Here no need to learn Java, okay, there is no need to learn the complete Java. If you are familiar with some concept, it's okay. Now what are the different features of the, now I got one question, so we cannot use Hive for unstructured data. Whatever the query related work is there, that can be used with the only structured data, similar to the SQL in the form of the RDBMS. So here the Hive is related only with the structured data, not the unstructured data. Clear? Now, there is some properties of the Hive which is similar to the SQL, and there something that is different from the SQL. So what exactly this Hive? So on the figure you may be able to see one diagram where there are certain features of the Hive. So first one, on the very left hand side, there is one box. There is one box. What exactly how fast the Hive query is? I got one question, how fast the Hive query is. So it will depends upon system. If it is working with the structured, then it will be fast as compared to the unstructured. Here on the left hand side, you are seeing that defines SQL like query language, that is known as the HiveQL. Again one question, that but it will run on the node, correct? Yeah, the whatever the concept we are dealing in the Hadoop, whether it is going for the MapReduce or with the pig, so all the concept will run on the nodes, because without node there will be nothing. If you have 1 billion of data in 1 billion row, okay, yeah, Asim, go ahead with your complete question. Means your question is how fast the Hive query if you have 1 billion of data in 1 billion rows. So whatever the concept you have that is familiar with the SQL, if it is a concept of the SQL, how fast it will be? It will take some time. So same concept is applied in the case of the Hive only. We have almost all the features similar to the SQL only, but certain extra features. So what are the extra features? We will see it, and then only you will be able to analyze which one is a better, means how it is going to be assessed. Again one more question. Okay, yeah, so here on the screen you may be able to see one of the features of the Hive, that is known as it defines the SQL like query language. So it's very common, as I told you that Hive is totally dealing with the structured data, and for dealing with the structured data, whatever the data we are using, whatever that query processing language we are using, it will be similar to the SQL only. Second one, second property, that data warehouse infrastructure. Yes, so whatever the data you are going to assess using this Hive, it will be first stored into the data warehouse. That's why it is known as the data warehouse infrastructure. Whatever the chatting message you are using in the Facebook, so it will be first stored. When you are going to assess that data, means what, when you are going to see your messages, then for that it will be, at that time it will be retrieved from that data warehouse only. Next one, that is allow programmers to plug in custom mappers and reducers. What exactly this means? So here we are dealing with a Hive that is related to the structured data, and here it is saying that it is related with the some custom mapper and reducer. It means that if you are dealing with a structure or an unstructured, there is no problem. how is data warehouse structure different from the database? So here what is happening, whenever you are going to deal with the Hive commands or the query, it will first converted into the mapper and reducer function internally. Okay. Now again, one more question is, how is data warehouse structure different from the HDFS? This data warehouse is only in the concept of the Hive, and that HDFS concept is totally in the case of all MapReduce and the Hadoop technology. So there is a difference between both of them. What is that difference? This difference is that HDFS is simply the file structure which is applicable to all the Hadoop concept, whether you are going to use any MapReduce, Pig or whatever. So that is the storage for the all. And it is HDFS is dealing with the unstructured one. Now here we have the data warehouse. How it is different? It is different because it is used only in the case of the Hive, and it is dealing with the structured data. I hope this point will clear your question, that HDFS is something related to the unstructured data, and it may be used throughout the Hadoop concept, and something that is the data warehouse, it is related to the Hive only, and it processes only the structured data, not the unstructured data. Okay, clear or not? Now the fourth property of this Hive is, as you are able to see it on the screen, that it provides tools to enable easy data ETL, means it is related to something ETL language. I hope you may be aware of, you have heard something about the estimated testing in the Informatica, something like that. So for that purpose, this Hive is basically used for the concept of the ETL. Now, on the slide, you may be able to see some use cases which leads the development of the Hive. If Hive was developed by the Facebook, how the Facebook developed this one? What was the problem? So here on the screen, one diagram is there in which you may be able to see that earlier from the starting, this traditional, the Facebook approach is towards the traditional RDBMS. What is the problem here? What are the challenges the Facebook is getting from this point, from the traditional RDBMS? First problem, that Facebook has millions of users. So the data size will be always greater. Second, it generates terabytes of data. It's again same reason, its data size will be very high. Again, third point, this is, that is the, its query more than 70k query per day. So if you are storing some data on somewhere in the RDBMS, then for processing that data will be somewhat slow as compared to the MapReduce or the Hadoop concept. So this is also one of the reasons. So this was the mainly reason that Facebook was facing, and for getting this solution, the after the RDBMS, the Facebook start using the concept of the MapReduce. Okay, because in the case of the RDBMS, the Facebook was getting some problem that it has the multiple millions of users and generating more data per day, and there may be a query processing per day more than 70k. So all are the problems that Facebook was facing in the RDBMS. Now after the RDBMS, the Facebook just contacted with the Hadoop MapReduce because it is somewhat more advantageous than the RDBMS. So Facebook contacted with the what? MapReduce. So what was the problem again here in the MapReduce? What is NoSQL and does it have to do anything with Hive? A question, Salni, that you have the question, what is NoSQL? NoSQL is also one of the database. Okay, and if you are moving in the advanced concept of the Hadoop technology, then you have to use for the NoSQL. Okay, because some of the technology in the Hadoop, we have something like the Cassandra, Mahout, so all are using the NoSQL data, where why this name has been given NoSQL, because it is not similar to any of, it is almost similar to any of the database you know, but there is no requirement for particular installation of this. Okay, you can simply download this file, move towards its shell directory, and you can type your commands. So here, till now, we don't have the anything relation with the NoSQL. Now, can anybody tell me what were the problems that the Facebook was facing from the RDBMS? Anyone? No one? Very good. First course answer. Huge data. Yeah, the data was huge. Then, you are right that Facebook was having the huge data. So, if you have the huge data, you have to move towards the Hadoop concept. In that Hadoop concept, we have the MapReduce. Then, what was the problem the Facebook we have Facebook faces in the concept of the MapReduce? What exactly the Facebook get the problem from the Hadoop MapReduce concept? One more answer. Multiple user. Yeah, the multiple user is okay, but what actually the problem was? Retrieval of this data. See, when the Facebook leave the concept of the RDBMS and move towards the MapReduce, then here the big problem of the Facebook was in the concept of MapReduce, that it was very hard to program. As you have seen, you have not seen the MapReduce programming in the Eclipse using the Java, so you are not familiar with that one. The one and mainly one problem of the Facebook with the MapReduce was that for each and everything it has to code, and which was the very hard, means it will take some more time, memory, everything. And second one was that if the users are knowing the SQL command, then why he should go for the Java programming for dealing with some same problem? Suppose if you are knowing the SQL command and you have to work with the SQL only, then why you should go for write such a huge Java program for getting the output? There is no need. So after getting this problem, that is the hard programming of the MapReduce or SQL problem, Facebook just started up thinking about itself and planned to develop one concept or the tool which can be solution for this problem, that it should be easy to program and it should be somewhat familiar to the SQL only. So for that purpose, the Facebook has generated the concept of the Hive. Any question in this one? Any questions? Any query? Any clarification? No. I think I have become the super trainer in the Hadoop. No one is going to ask any question. Now, we have some points. Means where to use the Hive and where to not use Hive. So tell me something. Where you are going to use the Hive? Tell me certain conditions where the Hive is required. On the figure, you may be able to see one diagram that is representing certain conditions when you are going to use the Hive, when the Hive application is going to be used. Very first answer I got is, that is the, where? Okay, so this Facebook generated the Hive, and this Hive was very much used, so analytic work can be done using Hive. It may be, if you are familiar with the analytic concept, you can use this Hive. I don't have any knowledge about the analytics, means the complete knowledge how the analytics is working, so I can't tell anything. Basically, this Hive is used for the log processing. As I told you that, what is log files? Log files is the semi-structured. So it may be considered in the structure or unstructured. and this hive is related something with the structure, so it can use the log processing work. Okay, then second one, that is the data mining. Data mining is also one of the concept which we are having the subject or on the one language that can be implemented using any of the language. So in that case we can use the hive. Okay, now again one query or the question, does hive has a statistic library? See, what actually is the hive is something that is related to the SQL only. So what are the different works you are performing on the SQL, you can perform whether you are going for the statistics or not. Okay, so what are the different features and the property of the statistics, we can see in the upcoming topics. Hive is also used in the document indexing. Why we need the concept of the indexing? What actually the indexing is? You have asked one question, that can we connect Hive with R and SAS? For R and SAS, we have the separate programming that is known as R programming in the MapReduce part. Okay, so Asim, I think your question is only related to the statistics. Okay, so for that we have one basic concept that is known as the R programming, that is only related to the okay. Give me 1 minute time, I'm getting some call that is important, so just be 1 minute. Hive is not a relational database. It is similar to the relational database, but not exactly the relational database. And it is not for the row level updates, because update command is not present in Hive. Then it is also not for the OLTP, means for the online transaction processing. It is for the only query processing, not the online transaction processing. Then what are the different features of the Hive? Hive features is that it is somewhat related to the SQL query processing, that is known as the HiveQL or HQL. It is almost familiar. Why? Because it is dealing with the most of the concept of the SQL only, so it is familiar, fast, scalable. Now you have to see the architecture of the Hive. Are you people able to see the architecture of the Hive on the screen? Any answers whether you are able to see it or not? I hope you may be able to see it. So this is the basic architecture of the Hive, where what is happening here. On the very bottom side, you may be find that HDFS or HBase data storage is there, because without HDFS, Hive can't work. That we have seen in the starting of the class, that Hive resides on the top of the HDFS. What exactly this you are seeing on the HDFS or HBase? What is this HBase? So HBase is also one of the data storage that we can see in our next tool or the technology. After the concept of this Hive, we have the topic that is known as the HBase. What is the meaning of the HBase? So we can see in the upcoming classes. Before going to that, we have to see here the architecture of the Hive. So here on the very bottom side, we have HDFS or the some data storage. Then on the top of that, we have this one that is known as the MapReduce, where in that MapReduce we have execution engine, what is required for running your Hive command. Then on the top of that you have the Hive processing language or the engine, this HiveQL process engine. This is the region where your Hive commands will be get executed. Here when you are dealing with the HiveQL, you may be able to use this metastores. If it is required, you can go for the metastore. On the top of this one, you may be able to see this part. This first part line is the user interface. So what is the user interface? You can be able, you may be able to get the answers from your sites only. What is user interface? The user interface, something which is visible to the users only. That is, it may be using the command live or web UI or some other technology. So how this architecture has been made, just see this diagram, and then after seeing this diagram, whatever the terms we have mentioned here, that is the user interface, web UI and MapReduce, execution engine, so all we have here defined. So first one we have on the top, we have seen the user interface. What exactly this user interface is? So what is the function of this user interface? So can anybody able to see on the screen and read that one? Yeah, I got one response from your side. Yeah, I can. Yeah, Asim, tell me, what is the operations, means what is the working of this user interface? The user interface is something that supports the Hive commands to interact with the users. Okay, then we have the meta stores where we are going to store the schema. Suppose if you are dealing with the MySQL, for each and every command in the MySQL, one schema will be generated. Okay, that can be seen by using the describe command in the MySQL. Describe table name, you will be able to see one schema. Schema means what? A schema means something, and that is the structure of how it is going to be stored in that one. So that in the case of Hive, that will be stored in the meta stores. That meta stores stores the schema or the metadata of the tables. Okay, now we have the HiveQL process engine, where your SQL query is going to be processed. Okay, whether it is normal or the MapReduce one. Then we have the execution engine, where we have to execute your SQL. Then we have the last one, that is the SDFS or HBase. Any one of them is required, because without any data storage, your Hive will not be able to work. Because if you are not having any storage area where your data will be stored. So for a storing purpose, we require the SDFS or one extra tool that is known as the HBase. Any questions right now? Does anybody having? No one is having. I am waiting for your responses. Some of your friends has left out the class due to some problem. But what about the remaining one? Remaining one, I got one question. No question. So now we have to see the working of the Hive. Means if Hive is installed in your system, and I told you that for working of the Hive SDFS is required. So how internally it is going to be work? Means what is the different processes we are required? Means when we are executing the Hive commands in our SDFS, what will be the different steps? So here, see on this diagram, you may be able to see this one, this left hand side part, that is the Hive part, and this right hand part is the Hadoop part. Okay, in this Hadoop part, the bottom one, we have the SDFS where name node and data nodes are present, and on the top we have the job tracker and task tracker. Okay, this concept is already clear to you. Okay, now we have to see how this Hive is going to interact with the Hadoop. Means what are the different steps? So see here, whatever the user interface you are providing, means from where you are going to process the Hive query command, so that will be first sent to the driver. Means your Hive query will be first sent to the driver, then from driver it will be going to contact with the compiler, where it will be all the internal working. Means from driver it will be going to the compiler, from compiler it will be going to the meta store. Why it is going to the meta store? For storing your schema of the query. Then from there meta store, it will be again returned. After storing your schema, it will return to the compiler, and from that compiler it will again return to the driver. Means from where it has been started, it will return to the driver only. Now what will be the steps from this driver? This driver will now contact to the execution engine, okay, where your Hive query is going to be executed. Then what will happen? At the same time, your execution engine will contact to Hadoop for processing your Hive commands, because whatever the commands you are going to process, the result will be stored in the SDFS only. So here a step is required that Hive will contact with the Hadoop, and after storing it will again return to the execution engine. Then from that execution engine it will return to the driver, means driver class, and from that driver class whatever the output you are able to get, or you are storing, or you are retrieving, the all the value will be sent to the user interface only. This diagram is clear to everyone? If it is not clear, just look at this diagram completely at once. See the diagram carefully, because in this diagram there is nothing. Everything is clear here only. Any questions? If you have any questions after seeing this diagram, just see this page. There are certain things which has been mentioned. So whatever the commands here which has been mentioned with the number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 to 10, so for all the numbers, for all the steps, what is going or what is happening, that has been given here. So see here, so on the very first hand side you may be see the step number 1. What is happening in the step number 1? Again I got a question that what is meta store. So Shalini, this meta store is something which is holding or storing the schema, that is the structure of your query. Suppose if you are going to create one table, how your table will look like? Means there will be one structure in which you may be able to see some column wise description. So that description or the schema will be stored in that meta store. So see here, what are the different steps that is mentioned with the numbers? So all the steps has been given some explanation here. First step was that the when the user interface is going to contact with the driver, what will happen there? So here the operation is the execute query, means whatever the query you have written on the user interface of the Hive, that will be executed. So the Hive interface, such as the command line or whatever the interface you are using, that will be executed. Okay. Then see here the second, from the driver it is contacting to the compiler. What is it means? It means simply that it is getting the plan. Means it will get the plans, means how your driver is going to work. So that plan will be taken in the step number 2. Then after that we have the step number 3, that get metadata, send metadata. So this can be helpful if you are just going to see your diagram once and getting the definition for each and every steps. So just see this diagram and try to read out. Means if you are getting any problem, means about the working of this Hive, just go through this explanation. And further, if you have any query, we can see that in the next class. Means if you have any confusion, any problem in this one, we can see it in the next class. Okay. Any response from your sides? Yeah, I got one response. Okay, thanks. Yeah. I will send the complete PPT, means whatever for the today and whatever the remaining, I will send all the PPTs in a single PPT. There may be certain modifications, means some other part will be modified later on this PPT. So this is not exactly the complete PPT, but whatever it is, I'll send you. Okay.